Moinsen Leute, wir sind wieder mal in Las Vegas 2017, Mr. Olympia und in New Orleans Arena und jetzt sitzen hier die Athleten und gleich kommen die ganzen Fans. Wir haben gerade schon draußen die Schlange gesehen, deshalb gehen wir mal ganz schnell mal zu den Fans, die ihr gerne ein bisschen mal hören wollt, was die so sagen. Außer jetzt die Pressekonferenz habt ihr ja auch ein bisschen mitgekriegt von Body Extreme. Da haben sich ja alle wieder mal lieb gehabt. Mal schauen, ob ich da was rauskitzeln kann. Okay, kommt mit. Okay Leute, jetzt haben wir hier auch schon einen Top-Favoriten der Men's Physikklasse schon seit 2 Jahren. Jeremy Potvin. How you doing, Jeremy?
Feeling alright, about as good as can be right now. Just ready to get on stage, do my thing and then eat some food. So.
Jeremy, what's the difference between 2016 Jeremy Potvin and 2017?
A little bit of everything. This year I have about 10 pounds of size on me. My conditioning is better. So, you know, I know everybody's made improvements, but we'll just see how I stand up and stack up with everybody else. But everything's different. So.
Okay, we heard it at the press conference. What do you think about you are the favorite, and Jeremy Buendia is a favorite, and the Ryan Terry, and what do you think about the guys?
I think everybody is amazing. They all look great. Jeremy's bringing it. Ryan Terry's bringing it. Andre is. Brandon. They all look phenomenal. But again, you know, I feel like everybody's made improvements. So it's just going to come down to who wants it the most and what the judges like that day. So.
So many fans from Germany want to know how is your diet? Is that low carb, high carb, high fat, or something?
So usually for my diet, I do a carb cycle when I'm prepping. Usually I'll do about 200 days followed by a high day, and then my fats stay relatively low at about 30 grams of fat. Protein's up there at about 300 to 350 grams of protein though.
Okay, and what's with cardio?
Cardio stays relatively low. It's been about 45 minutes this entire prep. So 45 minutes a day.
Sehr sympathischer junger Mann, der Jeremy Potvin. Und ja, wir wünschen ihm viel Glück. Good luck, Jeremy. And nice to meet you.
Likewise.
And I hope we see you at the FIBO in Germany.
Absolutely. Hopefully I can make it out there. I plan on it. So.
Yeah, really?
Yeah, absolutely. I'd love to.
Wir werden ihn auf der FIBO sehen und 2018 in Köln. Alles klar, danke schön, thank you very much.
Alright, thank you.
Good luck, bro. Okay, alles klar, Leute. Jetzt haben wir hier in Deutschland einer der bekanntesten Men's Physikathleten, Pro Ryan Terry. Ryan Terry, how you doing?
I'm very well, thank you. Yeah, getting excited, 2 days out. So, yeah, really can't wait for stage on Saturday.
I have a question. What is the difference between 2016 Ryan Terry and 2017?
So I'm hoping it's an improved Ryan Terry, but I've come in a lot bigger, I weigh more, and that was the feedback from the judges in 2016. I need to be slightly more 3D, a bit fuller on stage. So I went to work, and my off season was more about trying to get a bit more 3D, a bit more dense. I brought my arms up, that was a weakness in 2016, and I'm hoping I've done enough now to be more complete, ready for Saturday.
Okay, you told me last year your arms was not so big, and you growing up your arms, and now it's.
So I'm happy now because I was happy before, but over here they like to the oversized big full arm, so it was never a problem in previous shows, but with getting that feedback, it's something I always listen to my fans, my the judges. I always try and give what they want, so if they want bigger arms, that's what I've had to do on my off season, and yeah, I'm happy with the progress. There's still work to do, but obviously bodybuilding takes time.
Ryan, we see a lot of pictures at Instagram or Facebook or something. Are you the whole year in shape, shredded?
Yeah, well, I try to stay as conditioned as I can, purely because I class this as a lifestyle. I love what I do. I enjoy being in prep life. Don't get me wrong, I have cheats and I won't be competition ready all year, but I won't be far off photo shoot ready, because for me it's part of my job, but I enjoy being in shape. It's not a chore for me, so I don't enjoy carrying 40-50 pounds more than I need to. So again, I'd like to put a bit of weight on to gain muscle, but my objective is never to get big. It's just to stay conditioned and keep my shape.
Also er sagt, der ist fast das ganze Jahr über immer in Form, weil er diesen Lifestyle auch auch gerne lebe. Men's Physik sollte nicht so sein, dass man halt so fett ist und dann halt wieder alles abtrainiert, und so ist das auch genau richtig. Ryan, is that right, the Men's Physik class? It's 5 years old or 6 years old, I don't know. And the many people told me the first Mr. Olympia was Mark Anthony, and then Jeremy Bondia. And then Mr. Olympia, the second place and third place, was bigger and bigger and bigger. What do you think about that?
Yeah, it's very difficult because men's physique is quite a subjective class, because the top five always seem to be very different. So you can't really... you don't really know what they're looking for, because like I say, 1 year you've got Mark Anthony, who's a bit smaller, slightly wider waisted, and then you've got Jeremy, who's really small waisted, massive shoulders, massive arms, and every year they seem to be creeping up, getting bigger. And then last year they were trying to bring it back down, so they were placing people who were slightly smaller higher. So your guess is as good as mine. I'm over trying to guess what the judges want. I just focus on trying to be the best that I can be, and hopefully it's what the judges want.
And what do you think about classic physique? Sedek Hatzovic changed the class, and what do you think about that?
Well, I love classic physique. To be honest, I would love to grace the stage as a classic one day, but I'm realistic. I would never step on stage unless I'm a competitor. I don't want to just be a number, and for me, I'm quite light. For men's physique, I've only just reached the weight class and the size-wise they're looking for. So for me to jump into classic, I would need a few years off-season. It's a shame, because I'd love to show my legs off. Legs are one of my stronger parts, and I love training legs. But I'm realistic. Like I say, for a pro to step on stage as a classic physique is a big, big people, big guys.
Also ich habe ihn gerade gefragt, was er über jetzt die Men's Physikentwicklung sagt, dass sie immer bigger und bigger und bigger werden. Und dann sagt er, ja, okay, es ist halt seine eigene Klasse. Ich hoffe, die meisten Body Exchange Zuschauer haben das auch verstanden. Classic Physik habe ich noch gefragt, und da würde ich auch gerne mitmachen, aber dafür müsste er halt ein paar Saisons nochmal aufbauen. Und dann erst, aber er bleibt jetzt bei seinem Lifestyle, und ich frage ihn mal jetzt mal, ob er nach Deutschland wiederkommt. Are you next time in Germany?
I will be. Obviously, I'm at the FIBO every year, but I've done stuff with Marcus Ruhl, who's slightly behind you there, big guy, and he wants to do maybe a seminar in the future. So yeah, I think I'll be gracing Germany very soon.
And in Bremen too, it will shape you.
Yeah. Shape You's a great friend of mine. I like to associate myself with Shape You. So if they've got anything coming up, I will be there.
It's my hometown, Bremen. Okay. Thank you very much, Ryan. Nice to meet you again. Good luck.
Thank you very much.
Okay. And the last question. The top three in men's physique.
Me first. Andre Ferguson second, Jeremy third. Jeremy Buendia third.
Also, habt ihr verstanden? Andre Ferguson ist Zweiter, er ist Erster, und Dritter wird erst Jeremy Buendia. Okay, herzlichen Glückwunsch, Dankeschön. Thank you very much.
No problem. Okay. Appreciate it. Thanks, guys.
Okay, Leute, neben mir steht einer, der ist Shootingstar, Nathan DeAsha, der ist aus England, aber in Kuwait hat er jetzt sehr, sehr lange gelebt, beziehungsweise trainiert. Und jetzt werde ich ihm ein paar Fragen mal stellen. Nathan, you've been in Kuwait, and is your preparing only in Kuwait or in UK?
At the moment, only in Kuwait. I find that's where I'm more strict, and my head is more focused on my diet and training in Kuwait.
And how much is your weight now?
Now in kilo, we are around about 120 kilo.
Also Leute, 120 kilogram, and your height is in centimeter?
I don't know, in foot it's 5'9".
Okay, also er müsste jetzt so um die 1,80 so groß sein ungefähr, so wie ich, ja. Okay, and what do you think about the other guys, or do you don't think about the other guys?
I don't really think about them, to be honest. I just bring the best Nathan package that's possible. I believe last year I gave the judges a package to consider, to think about, so now this year I'm bigger, I know I'm a lot harder. And my strength last year was condition, so if I'm bigger with a lot more condition now, I hope they give me the right call out, and I get to show what I'm about, you know.
And what do you change in your preparing to 2017?
I took a long year off. I was told that I needed a thicker back and thicker legs and hamstring, so I then went back to the drawing board I didn't train much shoulder. I took time off on the shoulders and the arms. I trained back twice a week. I trained legs and hamstrings twice a week, and that was my main priority, because my shoulders and my arms are a strong point.
You never done that?
No, I've never trained twice a week, but for the past 4 weeks, I've trained shoulders, and they basically just caught up to my body. So I know I have a strong body part genetically regarding my shoulders and arms. So hopefully my back is now a strength. A lot of you guys can see on my Instagram and my YouTube that the back workouts are gruesome, the long and the hard, and I hope you can see the improvements.
And how many kilograms are more than 2016?
Around about 6.5 kilogram.
Also Leute, ich habe ihn jetzt gerade gefragt, wie viel Kilo er mehr hat seit letztem Jahr. 6.5 Kilogramm hat er aufgebaut, und er hat seine Arme und Schultern kaum trainiert, weil er da halt sehr, sehr gut Genetik hat, und er hat an seinen Rücken gearbeitet, Hamstrings hat er gearbeitet und Beine hat er dran gearbeitet, und mal schauen, was er da bringt. Der ist so ungefähr ja 1,80, so etwas, oder 1,79 groß müsste er sein, 120 Kilogramm, und what do you think is your chance this year or tomorrow at Saturday? Top 5 or top 10, what do you think?
I don't believe top 5. As much as I would like to get top 5, and I believe in the coming years I will be a top 5 Olympian. Really, being a realist, I think I can possibly get between 6 to 8. Last year a lot of people thought I got 7th. If they thought that this year, I should get 7th, you know. But just breaking the top 10 is a win for myself, because last year I got 12th, so if I get 10th, 11th, I know I'm improving. And that's really what it's about me improving. It isn't about the other guys, it's about myself, it's my own personal journey. And if I'm improving, that's good enough for myself.
What do you do in Kuwait? You, William Bonac, Big Remy. You are so different as the other guys from USA or from Europe. What do you do there?
We don't do much, to be honest. we don't do a lot. We eat, we sleep, we train. That's it. It's like the mecca of bodybuilding. Everything is just focused on gym, you know. It's the whole atmosphere is just gym, gym, gym. And that's all we talk about 24/7, you know. There's no, as you know, in Kuwait, there's no nightlife. So there's no chance to party. You can't go crazy on a weekend. So you're just sitting in, eating your meals, going to bed early, getting the right amount of rest and the nutrients. And that's what's paid off, because a lot of the time, we're back in the UK and Europe, I'd be doing bodybuilding Monday to Friday, and then I'd be hitting the town on Saturday. that's my downfall. But in Kuwait, it's just training 6 times a week and basically bodybuilding 7 times a week.
Do you have a coach?
Yeah, my coach is Ahmed Askar. He coaches myself, Rowley Winkler, and Ahmed Ashkarani. You know, he has three guys in the top 10 Olympia. So he knows what he's doing. He knows my body, and for me, that's the main thing, because my body, once it goes to diet mode, it goes crazy. I can easily drop 2-3 kilo in a day, you know. So for him to know this and to be on me 24/7, it's a good thing.
Also ich habe ihn gerade gefragt, was sie anders machen in Kuwait als die Jungs hier in USA oder in Europa. Also ich war selber da, er hat auch recht, also die haben keine Chance, Partys zu machen da. Schlafen, essen, trainieren, schlafen, essen, trainieren, und sonst gibt's nichts. Is your hometown Kuwait now, or is it in UK, no, your family?
My hometown is Liverpool. Still in the UK, you know, that will always be my hometown. Kuwait is just where I do bodybuilding. I would never move from my hometown, you know. I'm a Liverpool boy, born and bred, and that's where I'll be all my life. Kuwait is just a small step in my life, which I won't be there for a long time, but I'll be there for quite a while.
Also ich habe ihn gefragt, ob er jetzt ganz in Kuwait wohnt, aber er ist in Liverpool geboren, da wird er auch immer bleiben, also in England wird er sein. Und jetzt wollen wir mal fragen, ob er dann seine Bauchmuskeln sei. Can I see a little bit from your abs or something?
So, schaut euch das mal an, das ist Baklava.
Jawohl. Okay, thank you very much and good luck.
Thank you, brother.
And last question, top 5 for you.
My top 5?
Yeah.
Phil, Rami, Sean, Bonac, Dexter. Same as last year.
Okay, William Bonac sagt er, dass er in Top 5 ist. Okay, thank you very much, Nathan.
Danke.
And nice to meet you.
Danke, echt,
okay.
Take care.
So, cooler Typ.
Immer verfolgen, Instagram. So, moin Leute, wir sind immer noch hier in der Orleans Arena. Und neben mir steht die mehrfache Miss Olympia Fitness, die Erzrivalin von Regiane da Silva. Und ja, schauen wir mal, was sie jetzt noch vorhat. Oksana, nice to meet you here. Is that your last Miss Olympia, or do you think a couple of years? But you are so young.
It's hard to talk about it right now because my show tomorrow, and I'm so focused to do my best and, you know, to bring my best conditions and, of course, excited routine. But yes, suddenly this is my last Olympia, and so nothing more I'm gonna talk about it. Sorry.
Okay, and what's the difference between 2016 and 2017, Oksana? Are you now more shredded, or do you have another routine, or what is different?
Well, definitely. So I prep different routine, the new one, and it's very special to me. And
not Michael Jackson?
No, you saw Michael Jackson last year, right? So this is the another year, and it's more, it's very, I would call it final dance. So, and yeah, it's very meaningful performance for me, and definitely condition is getting just better and better, and I'm just, the only thing I'm sad about to leave the sport because of conditions, body's just muscles getting more mature, and it's just, you know, it's incredible, but I will continue on, of course, perform, I will be around, I'll be helping the girls, I will share my knowledge with them, it's just, you know, I want to just, yeah.
Okay. Do you do something for this sport after your career as a coach or something? Or
yes, I have big plans, and for second year I'm promoting OG Pole Fitness, and you know, my career is just, it's blessed because I have learned so many fitness brands like Cirwheel and Pole Fitness, and I have so many friends right now, so who I can help and promote new fitness brands, and definitely I will work with fitness girls now I have time, and you know, to help them, because when you do professionally sport, it just you have to choose. You cannot do both, or you'll be just not improving. So if you wanna be, if you wanna leave something in the sport after yourself, you have to sacrifice a lot. And so I did, and now I'm glad that I will have some free time to share my knowledge with new fitness competitors and just help them, you know, with routines and everything.
Do you want to come to Germany to the FIBO or posing? Yeah. Really?
Of course, I love being in German. It's one of my favorite places because my city, actually, I'm from Russia, very close to German, and it's kind of when I visit German, it reminds me about my home city. So yeah, I love German, and all my German fans, I love you so much.
Do you speak German a little bit for your fans?
Actually, I studied German in school and in university. You can't believe, yeah, but I nicht verstehe. Right now, I'm nicht verstehen. Yeah, I learned, but I forgot.
You can say to your German fans goodbye or something in German.
Goodbye. It's gonna be.
Tschüss.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Yeah.
Ich liebe dich.
Ja, also sie liebt dich. Ich hoffe, du sie auch. Okay, das war Oksana Grischina und sie macht ihren letzten Wettkampf. Schauen wir mal, wie das mit Regiane da Silva aussieht. Und ja, und dann werden wir natürlich sehen. Thank you very much. Nice to meet you. And I hope I see you in Germany.
Oh yes.
Okay?
I hope.
With a better language in German.
Okay.
Please. Okay?
Only with better. Okay. Okay. Bye guys. Love you so much. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay. So Leute, gleich sind wir auch schon bei Jeremy Buendia. Das ist der amtierende Mr. Olympia, werdet ihr wahrscheinlich kennen. Okay, jetzt sind wir hier auch schon beim amtierenden Mr. Olympia. Jeremy, how are you doing today?
Doing good, man. It's been quite a prep, man. I've been very excited to be here. It's been the best prep I've had yet, so I'm excited to show everybody what we put together here in 2017.
I never seen your face so like this here.
Well, it looks like down here too.
Okay. Can I see your abs there? No.
Yeah, you can see it on Saturday.
Okay, also ich habe gefragt, ob man seine Bauchmuskeln sehen kann, aber er will das nicht zeigen, aber er ist immer so. Das war auch in Kuwait so. Und denke ich mal, dass er da ein bisschen Spannung da reinbringt und ist auch in Ordnung. Jeremy, what's the difference between 2016, Jeremy Buendia, und 2017?
It's a more complete package. I mean, I'm a lot bigger on stage, a lot fuller, a lot more mature muscle, better density, better conditioning. You're going to see it's an all-around better athlete on stage and you guys are going to be shocked when you see the physique I put together. It's a lot different than last year.
We saw a lot of videos and pictures of you. You have legs, damn, it's very good. Do you think about classic physique?
No, I'm not thinking anything farther than Saturday right now. So I got 2 days ahead of me that I gotta focus on and I'll write my future after that.
Okay, ich habe ihn gefragt, also weil er so heftige Beine hat, ob er über Classic Physik denkt, aber daran denkt er nicht nach. Er denkt nur an morgen und übermorgen. Ist auch klar. Okay, it's thank you very much, Jeremy. Nice to meet you too. And good luck. And last question, the top three men's physique for you.
I don't have any predictions, man. Whoever gets in there, be happy to see him in there.
Okay, you are number one and number two and three.
I don't have any predictions, bro. I don't have anybody just to say. Could be anybody.
Okay, sag nichts über Top 3. Okay, trotzdem Dankeschön. Thank you very much, Jeremy. Nice to meet you. Schlecht gelaunt, denke ich mal, aber ich kann mir vorstellen, dass er gerade sehr, sehr, sehr heftig unter Druck steht. Sah megamäßig knochig aus im Gesicht. Also darunter muss wohl eine richtig heftige Form sein. Schauen wir mal, bin echt gespannt. Okay, Leute, jetzt seht ihr auch schon den amtierenden Mr. Olympia, Phil Heath. Und hier ist die Schlange schon da, obwohl die Tore noch nicht mal geöffnet sind. Es ist hier schon 100 Meter Schlange. Gleich wenn die Tore geöffnet sind und wenn die Fans reinkommen, dann wird man hier sowieso nicht mehr durchkommen. Deshalb lass uns mal nach oben hingehen und ein paar dicke Jungs erwischen. So Leute, jetzt sind wir hier auch so schon bei dem Shooting Star der Classic Physik Klasse. Habt ihr bestimmt schon öfter mal Bilder gesehen bei Instagram. Hi Chris, how are you doing today?
Good, I'm feeling good. Got some food in me now, so I got a little bit more energy, but I feel great, yeah.
Okay, what's your weight today?
My weight, I weighed in at 223.5, so a pound and a half under my weigh-in, so perfect weight, yeah.
This is your first Mr. Olympia show, right?
It is, yeah.
And how many Classic Physique shows you did in the last time?
I've competed in 3 Classic Physique shows now.
Yeah. You win?
I came 3rd in one and then I won the next 2, so yeah.
What do you think about the other guys from Classic Physique? The other guys, Darim Charles or Sadi Katsovic or Ara Schrapper or Danny Hisser.
I mean, I have nothing but respect for all of them. That's why I love this class. We all have such different looks. We're all different heights, different weights. And I mean, everyone looks so amazing. And Classic Physique is it's a pretty broad term when you think about it. Everyone's bringing their own favorite look. So it really depends what the judges want. Also, of course, with the crowd. But I think everyone's physique is amazing. Everyone that I've seen is absolutely shredded. So everyone's got the conditioning down. It's going to depend what the judges are looking for.
Do you want to change the class or do you want to stay at Classic Physique or to the big guys in the next years? You are so young.
Right now I'm definitely thinking of just staying here, but like you said, I'm very young, so a couple of years here, and if it keeps treating me like it is, then I'll stay here for sure, because I like, this is how I want to look right now. I don't want to have to push my weight too much to get too big, but I really like the classic look and being able to stay at this weight and stay like athletic and healthy. So
are you the whole year in shape and shredded, or what's your weight in the off season?
I usually have to stay decently lean. I'm up to 245 to 250 max, so about 20 pounds over my stage weight. But if I get too big, then I won't be able to make weight when I come down. So I always have trouble cutting down to my weight limit. So I try and stay as lean as I can.
Mm-hmm. Can we see a little bit from your body, abs or biceps or something?
Leg or something?
So, die Beine. Alter Schwede. Guck dir diese Kerben nochmal an. Der Typ ist der Hammer. Oh, that's amazing. And how many years do you train?
I've been training for like 7 years, I guess. Competing for 4, but training for 7. But
seit 7 Jahren trainiert er und seit 4 Jahren macht er erst Wettkämpfe. Okay, thank you very much, Chris. And do you want to come to Germany, FIBO or something?
Oh, I'd love to, yeah. My one sponsor, MHP, I think they were planning on going to FIBO this year, so I'm hoping they bring me. I would love to go down there, yeah.
Also Leute, MHP Stand nächstes Jahr, FIBO, Chris Bumstead, Shooting Star, wir drücken ihm die Daumen, good luck bro and see you.
Appreciate it.
Thank you very much. So Leute, jetzt sind wir hier bei Brandon Curry und er hat ja in den letzten Monaten, Jahren richtig was getan bei Brandon. Brandon, nice to meet you here.
Yes, me too, man.
Brandon, you are so different. Your body is so different. The last 2 years, what's happening?
Well, you know, I went over to train at Oxygen Gym and started working with my coach. He's somewhere around, you know, Abdullah, he's somewhere around.
Abdullah?
Yeah, Abdullah, yeah. And he's just been finding the right formula for me. And I just being able to focus solely on bodybuilding has been really the big difference for me. You know, I balance family life and, you know, practices and all kind of schedules when I'm at home. So when in Kuwait, it's just all bodybuilding, man, just all 24/7. I can't get away from it.
Is Kuwait now your hometown?
It's not my home, but I've spent more time there this year than I have spent at home. So, yeah, this year has been a lot of work done, a lot of groundwork done. So, you know, maybe I won't have to spend as much time because I won't be prepping as long. We made some dramatic changes, but I'll still go out there and I'll train with my coach and prep for shows. So, but this year was the breakout year, so I needed to spend as much time as possible to make the improvements that I need to make this a big year for me.
The people say always you are a big talent, big talent, big talent, year for year, year for year. And now it's your time in the last years. Do you put a lot of weight on your body or is that only...
In comparison, I'm probably, if you compare me to last year on the Olympia stage, I'm probably technically 30 pounds heavier on stage than I was last year. So it's a dramatic difference in weight as well, along with the muscle maturity that's coming as well as I age. So yeah, it's the real deal, man. It's a dramatic difference. And the comparison pictures even from me from last year's Olympia to the shirts I did early in the year were dramatic. And I made improvements upon on that as well. So it's going to be interesting to see how I look on stage.
And what do you think about the other guys from Kuwait? Big Remy and Nathan and William Bonac. Is that all the same preparing or is it different or what do you make there?
We all have different bodies, so we all have different coaches. William Bonac's not with the crew, I'll correct you on that one. But Nathan, Rowley, Ashkenani and Big Remy, as well as myself. And we all have different strategies and we all work with different coaches. So they depending on our bodies, depending on how we respond, what they learn about us, we do different things. Sometimes we're in the gym training at the same time. Sometimes they pair us up for certain body parts. And then sometimes we're training all by ourselves or, you know, depending on what our coaches want from us and what we got to bring out. So sometimes it's teamwork, team effort. Sometimes it's very individualized, you know, just depending on our needs. So.
What do you think about the top five in the big class, the heavyweight boys?
Well, you know, it's. I feel it's wide open. I feel the ground is shaking up under everybody this year, and it's a good opportunity for, you know, some changes within that top five that's been, you know, just solid for so long. Like the only breakout guy in the top five in the past few years has been Williams. So I think it's going to be more change this year. I don't think everybody's going to come in as strong as they have in previous years, or maybe they say they have. So I think the door is wide open. It's a good opportunity to make some good changes and in the top five. So
hey, cool.
I hope to be a part of that. So hopefully we'll see.
We hope so. And you've been in Germany, yes, a lot of times. And and next time.
The next time I'll be in Germany, man, let's see. That's a good question. It'll probably be fairly soon. I was in Germany at least a couple times this year already. Oh, 3 times this year already for 2 days guest posings and then FIBO, of course. So I'll at least be there by FIBO, I think, next year. But I typically guest pose in Germany as well. So, you know, you never know what the schedule is going to come up. So.
Also wenn ihr einen Gastposer braucht hier in Deutschland, dann könnt ihr gerne hier Brandon Curry engagieren. Ist echt der Hammer. What's your weight now?
You know, we're about 2. You see, like, we're about 250 pounds, or I guess 116 kilos right now for the stage. We're gonna try to get down there for the stage with the dehydration and the carb up effect. We'll probably be right around that range. So that's the goal. Everything's going good so far. You check online, see the pictures, guys, if this is going up pretty soon. I think Louis Marco posted some, my coach posted some, and we just took those a few minutes ago in the, after tanning. So things are going really, really well. So hopefully stay on track, and we'll just cruise right into tomorrow and ready for the evening show.
I wish you good luck and thank you very much. Nice to meet you here. And ja, Dankeschön sagen wir hier an Brandon Curry. Wir drücken ihm die Daumen und nächste Zeit in Deutschland. FIBO wird er auf jeden Fall da sein und wahrscheinlich auch zum Gastposen. Thank you very much, Brandon, and good luck für tomorrow. Okay. So Leute, jetzt habe ich hier den Topstar, Sergi Constanze, und schauen wir mal, was er dazu sagt. Sergi, it's your first time here, Mr. Olympia. How many years are you pro in men's physique?
I'm this year, I become pro last year, so I'm old this year. I compete on my first pro stage last April in Chicago Pro. So I won and I qualified to Olympia. And this is my first Olympia. I'm really excited. I'm like a little kid, but yeah, I'm enjoying so much. Finally, I did this goal in my life. I wanted to do so bad, being the Olympia, competing with the best. And finally, you know, a goal that I get it and I'm here and I'm gonna fight for the Olympia.
And what do you think your chance here at the Olympia? You see the guys, Jeremy Buendia and Jeremy Potvin or something. What do you think your chance?
They are great athletes and I respect them so much. Are really good athletes. They looking amazing. The physics are so good. So yeah, I will try to my best and I will try to be in the top. You know, everybody wants to be first, me too. But I respect so much every athlete, you know. They are working hard like me, but I work so hard. So we will see.
And how many months were you preparing? 3 months, 4 months?
You know, for me it's not about preparing for the competition. It's like it's my lifestyle, so I'm not 12 weeks prepping. No, I'm like, I'm all year round ready to be on stage. Maybe I do diet more strict, more clean the last weeks. But now it's like, for me it's like a lifestyle, you know. I don't believe in the bulk or off season or I try to eat. Sometimes more, sometimes less, depending on the goal. Now the goal is to be ripped, so I must eat for that.
And how is your diet? Is that low carb, high carb or something, or low fat?
Maybe you can see in the YouTube, in my YouTube. You know, last on Tuesday I was in the Five Guys. It's a burger store, so I was eating burgers.
Also hat gestern noch Burger gegessen.
It's a lifestyle, you know, it's depending on how you do. But I think if you train hard, do it well, you can, you know, you can eat everything.
Yeah. Okay, thank you very much, Sergi, and good luck for tomorrow. And we see you in Germany next time or not? In Germany?
I don't know yet.
FIBO?
I don't know yet.
Okay, alles klar. Er weiß noch nicht, wann er in Deutschland ist, aber in Spanien ist er auf jeden Fall. Du bist in Barcelona, Mr. Olympia.
I'm going to the Arnold Classic Barcelona next weekend. I will be there with my booth of Be Legend Collection brand. And then, I don't know, I have so much trips until December. But FIBO, I don't know if I will go. I need to talk with, you know, the owners of FIBO.
Okay, gracias, Sergi.
Encantado. Un placer.
Bye-bye. Leute, jetzt haben wir eine große Runde gedreht, ein paar Jungs gesehen und ein paar Mädels natürlich. Jetzt kommen alle Fans hier rein, wie ihr sehen könnt. Jetzt sind die Tore geöffnet und ich habe wirklich noch nie so viele Leute vor der Tür gesehen wie heute. Also die letzten Jahre war es auch schon immer voll, aber diesmal ist es richtig brutal voll. Keine Ahnung, es wird spektakulär. Und ich werde mich gleich hinlegen und schön schlafen und ihr könnt machen, was ihr wollt. Haut rein, aus. Jetzt haben wir eine...